I learned that I was at a little plateau in my career and I needed something to light a fire under me, and the Ritu matchup did just that. And now I'm only going up from here. I'm more motivated than ever. I'm hungry than ever, and it was great for me. I never lost confidence. I've always fought the best of the best. I've always put on great performances. What the victory over Ritu did for me was gave me momentum. I don't think that's the same thing as confidence. I've always believed in myself, always believed I was one of the best, and could be the best one day. It was amazing for me emotionally and career-wise, as far as momentum of just giving me that drive again. I didn't really talk to Ritu after. The only time I talked is I was telling her, this is the first time fans have ever sent me death threats, and they've gone as far as they've had. And since she held so much star power, I asked her kindly to tell her fans to back off a little bit, and she was nice enough to do that. But no, we haven't talked about it. But her believing she it being controversial, one, because she has a lot of fans, so they're quite emotional and biased. But also, it was a classic grappler versus striker, and I just think I did more in the striking than did she did in her realm. But as a fighter, I can understand why she thought she won, as she should. It was a close decision. I just don't think any of these opinions take away. It's a lot of noise and a lot of opinions, and none of it takes away from my victory, and none of it takes away from what I did in the cage. I've been doing this for a long time, and I have a good ego. I don't have a bad ego, which means I'm not in here to prove anything to anyone. And I know myself. I know I won. I know I did a good job. And there's things in my career I need to do. I need to claim more wins. I need to get back in the winning column. I need to, if I'm not on the Grand Prix, I need to keep winning new names, keep climbing the ranks so that I can get to the title contention sometime. And I know that emotional fans and emotional people want the rematch. Sure, they love her. They should want it. That doesn't mean I'll give it to them. It's not in the path of, it's not conducive to what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to get to the top. I think Jenalyn is tough. Jenalyn is bigger, which is nothing new to me, and she hits hard. For me, I just think I have way more ways to finish her. I have way more ways to win, and I think that she's slower than me. I think that so with that, with the power but minus the speed, I can predict her and I can steer her where I want to and take the fight where I want to. I'm at Extreme Couture, and I've been at Extreme Couture before, and I've lost. I think that a big gym means that you have all the resources. Doesn't mean that just because you have a good teacher doesn't mean that you're going to be the great student and you're going to win. Some diff all camps are different. Her coming from Lakai doesn't mean anything certain. It just means that she has the right tool. So I'll be watching out for it. But this specific camp at Extreme Couture, I've really leveled up my grappling. And I've really changed my perspective in who I am. I used to identify as a striker, and I'm not sure where that came about, but I am an MMA fighter. My grappling is dangerous, and I can't wait to showcase it. Those are all emotional questions, right? What I want people to perceive, what people do perceive. It doesn't really matter. At the end of the day, I have striking, she has striking. I have grappling, I have better grappling, I have better wrestling, and she doesn't. So the smarter thing to do is to use my grappling and take it to the ground. But if that doesn't work, that's going to open up my striking even more. I literally have nothing to prove when it comes to striking and battling it out. Obviously, my legacy, my fights speak for itself. So what I do need to prove to myself is that I can be the smarter fighter and take the shorter, less resistant path, which is taking her down and finishing her. I think being outside of the Grand Prix with the complications of the Grand Prix, anybody, I think me, I just need to keep knocking people down. I just need to keep stepping on these stepping stones and make sure that I'm somewhere at the top or near the top when that Grand Prix is done. That is my only job, and names have no interest to me. I obviously, most of the people I want to fight is already in the Grand Prix. So if you're asking me that question outside the Grand Prix, it doesn't matter who it is. I'm hoping Stan, I'm really rooting for Stan Fairtex just because after battling somebody, and you just have so much respect for them. And that fight was such a battle, and I learned so much from it. My idea of a good time would be Stan Fairtex being champion and me fighting her for it. Somebody's gonna get finished. If I really screw up and run into one of her power punches, that'll be my fault. I don't see that happening. I've trained against it, but I really just think I'm gonna drag her to deep waters and I'm gonna drown her.